Hello, Tango friends. Welcome to Patricio Neva's Tango class. As always, we see you every Saturday here. And today we are going to start with a new series. As you can see, it's called Advanced Tango Figures. That's the name of this series that we are going to do. And it doesn't matter the level you are, even if you say advanced, you can always learn something from it, okay? Even if it might be too difficult for some of you, it's okay. You know, you will get something out of it for sure. Okay, and before we go forward with the class, I want to say thank you so much to my friend Cristina Delon for the beautiful jewelry. See what I'm wearing today? I really love this. Wow, it's so cute. Okay, thank you. So if you're interested in her jewelry, I will post the link so you can go and check it out, okay? And now I wait for Patricio to join me.
Yes, yes. I'm here. I'm just checking to see that everything goes well. You look especially bright today.
Yes, I think we have a couple of changes in the, look at that. Oh, wow. I think someone is having fun with the new switcher that we have. And we installed, yes, very convenient.
Mira esto.
I like it. Oh, look at that.
Look at that.
Good guys. As you can see, we are happy with it.
We got
with
the
new toy.
See, we got the camera switch connected and going, and it's working great. Are you happy about it?
Very happy, yeah.
Good. So hot today here. There's a heat wave in the US. And we are loving the summer these days. Here we're expecting to have 10 days of full sunshine.
Correct. Let's see if that is truth. If not, we are going to enjoy it anyways.
Of course. Today we begin a new series. Mm-hmm. People might have noticed there is a new title up there.
Yeah.
Advanced Tango Figures.
We said that
at the same time.
I did it on purpose. Okay.
We have a new series beginning today. Mm-hmm. Advanced Tango Figures. I don't even know the name.
Okay. Yeah, we prepared a nice combination for you of figures. So let's see how far you can get with them. We have fun doing this.
The first thing that we're going to do is explore a little bit the first two steps of the turn. Today's movement is a combination. When we talk about advanced tango figures, we talk about beginning to combine simple elements like sacadas, turns. I mean, each of them individually are more simple. And we're going to make them more complex, combining them together.
Mm-hmm.
So the first thing I think we could do is work a little bit in the turn, because this is going to be a movement that requires turning and balance.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's do that.
So we should get a little bit of inspiration in the ocho cortado, which begins with a step forward, a pivot, and a step side.
Correct.
And then a triumph way of weight, forward, pivot, and then side.
Okay.
These two places of the turn are very important. We go, for example, we go crossing. This is the role for the follow. We go crossing, pivot side, transfer way, crossing, pivot side, transfer way. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. So right here I advance in a straight line, but I cross the upper body. So at the moment I'm fully transferring my weight, I'm pushing from the back. I'm ready to rotate and then transfer my weight side. Notice how I always have projection. I first put my leg out, then I transfer my weight. First put my leg in front, then I transfer my weight. I don't advance with my hip and my foot and my face all at the same time. This is very important for the movement that we're going to do, because today we're going to work on
I need to do with the foot. Beep.
Yeah, like a guitar. Yeah. You, because you're heavy metal, that's why.
Yeah. I need to use the heel, the little heel, la dita.
Yeah. Oh, I see.
What about that?
Yes. Okay. Claro, la diva del tango. Como las LOL dolls.
Okay.
So one. We go forward, pivot,
side, two. Transfer way. Forward, pivot, side, transfer way. Forward, pivot, side. I'm going to bring again the same concept that we talked about last week, counter body rotation. And that moment in which you, I like the combination, green necklace with the green dress. Beautiful, Eva.
Yes.
You look
I put
so
the dress, actually, this dress, because of the necklace.
Oh, okay.
So it was the other way around. Yes, it was. I want to use this necklace. So what can I wear?
You look beautiful.
That's the way it was. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. Okay, so
green,
that's
green like nature. Maybe that's why.
Yeah.
The extension to the side is important, as it is the counter body rotation. See, when I go forward, I don't put my right foot in front of my right hip. I put my right foot in front of my left hip, and I bring my upper body facing towards the right, outside the hip. This is what brings the torsion of the body to this point here, where I can engage and rotate my hip after that. Shoulder rotate the hip. Shoulder rotate the hip. Now, when we do these turns, can we do this exercise together? So everybody at home, if you have somebody to do this together, you can do this with somebody, otherwise you can do this by yourself. Let's just walk about 45 degrees. And then we step a pivot 90 degrees from it in relationship to that previous step, and then we step again parallel to each other. And then we pivot again, and then we reach back. And then with no pivot, then go side again. And then go forward, pivot, side, pivot, back, no, side, no, forward, side, back, side, forward, side, back, side, forward. Change direction, forward, side, back, side, forward, side, back, side, forward, side. And that is the position that we're looking for. Yeah, you see, when there is flow, then you can work with the energy. So you have to create the flow. It's very important that the follow goes. A lot of the time we see that the hesitation, you know, that the follow is expecting the lead to move before she moves. In reality, we follow you. We are leading you because we ask you something, but then we end up following you because we work in relationship to you. So if the follow doesn't move until the lead moves, then there is no initiation here. So she needs to go so I can put my leg in. Once she's opening, I can sense that, and then I put my foot in the space. This is going to be the first movement in it. That is why I'm making such a point about having strong projections, clarity right here. See, this is a low sacada. This is a high sacada. See, we're combining a turn with sacadas, a low one, and then a high sacada.
So I would say that that's why when Patricio said that from this position, we turn and we go 90 degrees, sometimes more, it depends what we are doing. In this case, you need to go close to your partner because we are trying to do the first sacada. So think in the ocho cortado, like literally. Because the ocho cortado, you have that, okay? So think on this position for the low sacada, and think on this position for the high sacada. And as he said, very important is that we, not only the follow, but the lead, get really, really used to transfer your weight from one leg to the other before you pick up the foot, okay? It's very common that we rush the picking up of the foot, and then the sacada is not possible, okay? So as you are going for the first step and you receive the sacada, turn and transfer. See, I project, as soon as I'm feeling I need to go there, I project and I transfer my weight. So as I'm transferring, my partner is going to get in this leg, so by the time I complete my weight transfer, I will do the sacada. I will tie the leg because it's a high sacada. So I will tie the leg and then we are going to combine that with the voleo. Okay, so that's the idea. For now, but it's very nice the way we will exit the voleo. So let's do this first part.
I think I see the people that are there, they're watching. Tom is with us.
Richard from Canada, they say hello.
Hello guys, thanks for being there.
Yeah, thank you so much.
You are the real hardcore true tangueros that are dancing in the summer. You know, everybody goes off on vacation, they take a break, but when you're dancing when it's 100 degree weather, that's when we know where your heart really is.
Exactly, exactly.
So everybody should try this by themselves. You forward, feel the moment in which you leave your foot behind, go side, and then do the boleo. Because this boleo has a particularity. It has less pivot than a normal boleo. One thing is the boleo that comes out of a back ocho that has an existing pivot of the back ocho. So then you go like this, like that. In this case, I'm pushing the leg as I enter on the second step, and I apply pressure as I push. So I go cross in the first sacada, forward, which becomes size on the second sacada. See, and so I try to go high on her thigh. We did high sacadas and low sacadas in our classes. The low sacada, or sacada baja, is a sacada onto the foot. The high sacada is a sacada into the thigh. So I'm trying to make connection here with her inner thigh, right in between the knee and the top of the femur, mm-hmm. right here. So as I move into it, I turn. So I try to enter forward and then I finish sideways, because during the progression of the weight transfer, I continue to pivot to push my partner with the outside of my thigh. Mm-hmm. Here, the disassociation is crucial. Let's put you in front of the camera, please. I want people to see how I push you away to come back at me. This way. You see, guys, this is my perspective. When I can see the far foot, I have the clearance to do a sacada effectively. But now I'm already aware of this inner thigh here and how I cannot see it yet. But as we continue advancing, I turn myself into it. So I'm in front of it and I can send my leg in, then push that leg to the side. So I want everybody to do that. I went sideways with this, but I want to go so they understand what's going on. I want everybody to go forward. Side, swing the leg, boleo, and then forward. Because as you can see, it's not the same boleo as in the back ocho. It's a side step boleo and it's on a high sacada. So it makes sense that you only move your leg from the hip joint mm-hmm. without turning your butt, without turning your bottom foot, at least not as much.
Well, we are in the position already, kind of, yeah, at the end of the weight transfer.
And I'm here again.
Yeah, right now. But then we are going to...
Yes, I'm going to enrosque to it.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Sacada, high sacada, boleo. You see how strong I hold my partner there? You gotta firm up the frame.
Yeah. Would you like to dance a little bit?
We haven't danced today, right?
No, I think we should dance a little bit, yeah.
Oh, acá tenemos a Matías Taucedas que dice, saludos, tío, desde Argentina. Mira, mi sobrino me está mirando. Hola, Matías. Después acá tenemos a Aida Elena Gilaberti, que dice, buenas noches, chicos. Es una noche muy fría en Buenos Aires. Claro, allá están en el lado opuesto del planeta.
Claro,
están
ahora
los días
hace frío.
Cortos y las noches frías. Abrazos desde Palm Desert, dice Cristina. Very cool effects. Sí, Richard, the effects are very cool. I'm very happy with that. We got a lot more to incorporate with the switcher.
Yeah, this is just the beginning of the switcher.
Tom Lee says hello as well.
Yeah. Tom Lee always present, always there.
Bruce also, and
Bruce
the knees.
Bruce and the knees, yeah. Okay, we are going to dance, I guess, right?
Yes. Okay, we're going to try to do that movement.
Okay,
vamos a bailar una canción que se llama Bailemos. Thank you.
pares, no muchacha, la gente está mirando. Bailemos este tango, el tango del adiós. Así entre mis brazos, mirándote a los ojos, yo quiero despedirme sin llanto y sin dolor. La vida caprichosa nos puso frente a frente, prendiendo en nuestro pecho la hoguera de un querer. Mas hoy la misma vida nos manda a separarnos. El sueño de querernos, ya ves, no puede ser. Bailemos como antes, cariñito, abrazados bien juntitos, solo un alma entre los dos. Bailemos, que no vea en tus pupilas ni una lágrima furtiva, ni una sombra, ni un dolor. Bailemos, que después ya sin tus ojos he de arrancar un sollozo por mi amor y por tu amor. Siempre estarás en mi desvelo, como una estrella en el cielo prendida en mi corazón. No intentes revelarte, lo nuestro es imposible, un sueño irrealizable que nunca floreció. ¿Qué importa que nos una un mismo sentimiento y encienda nuestras almas la antorcha del amor? Que tengas mucha suerte, que Dios no te abandone. Yo sé que a mí me espera la eterna soledad. No tiembles en mis brazos, te ruego me perdones. El tango ya termina, salgamos a llorar. Ya sin tus ojos he de arrancar un sollozo por mi amor y por tu amor. Siempre estarás en mi desvelo, como una estrella en el cielo prendida en mi corazón.
Very nice, eh? That was great.
Bajar nice. Volumen, subir volumen.
Yeah, that was good. Yeah.
I did it. The good thing is, the bad thing is that I didn't do the step, not a single one.
Yeah, you did.
Not a single time.
You did.
I did a part of it, but...
Well, you didn't do the second part, but we did the first part that we shall explain, so I think that's good.
To be honest, Yes, exactly. I tried to do the sacada part and I ended up doing the voleo part as well.
Sacada voleo, yeah.
Yes. So you see, you got to try to look for the opportunity in which the follow crosses in front and then she unfolds this beautiful ocho. And then you put your right foot forward. You go forward. Pivot a lot. Mm-hmm. To be into the voleo. You see, it's like the upper disc turns, and then the lower disc has to turn faster. The follow is moving clockwise. So if you don't go ahead of her to wait for the moment in which she separates her thighs, you will always be chasing her as she moves clockwise. So you have to go, you have to pass her. That is why the disassociation. I go on the first one quickly here, but notice how my left shoulder is back and my right elbow is forward. That means my partner is about here, which gives me, when she's about 9, I could be putting my foot about 11, and then by the time she is by 12, 1, and then I fully put my weight at 11. And then she kind of collapses, she crashes a little bit with my thigh. It's not that I'm the one who pushes so much away, it's kind of like I want to push sideways, not directly into your thigh.
It's a weight transfer, mostly, right?
Forward, I pivot quickly and I advance, see? And then I rotate as I apply pressure with my thigh. So I'm firm here in my thigh, in my hip, so as to not collapse like this and be the one who actually displaces my partner's leg, and then it will create a new orbit for her foot. And if she is connected with what's happening, she will finish that straightening, feel an increase in the tension between the push of the saccada, and then at that moment she will know she needs to find the far side.
Exactamente. Yeah, that's okay.
Bien. Voy a decir rapidito en español lo que dijo Pato. Que en el momento que él va a entrar a la sacada, acelera su pivot para poder estar a tiempo, listo para meter la pierna cuando la mujer todavía no transfirió el peso. Si ustedes observan, en el momento que él mete la pierna y la prepara para la sacada, yo estoy transfiriendo mi peso acá. O sea, estoy con el peso repartido en las dos piernas, en el momento que su pierna entra en el lugar correcto para que cuando yo termine de transferir el peso, sienta esa presión en la pierna. Entonces no es necesario que él empuje ni nada. El mismo cambio de peso hace que la sacada funcione. ¿Okay? So, entonces para los leads, tengan en cuenta el momento en que adelantan la cadera para estar listos para el momento de la sacada. Porque tienen que hacer como un sneak de la pierna. Tienen que meter la pierna y transferir el peso. ¿Sí? Tiene que ser el momento que la mujer tiene peso en las dos piernas, que está en el medio, ¿ok? De la transición.
Ajá, muy bien. Vos sabés que ahora que te miro y vos tenés la pollera corta, se ven las piernas, se ve muy claramente el movimiento. Estaba pensando que yo tendría que ponerme shorts para mostrar los pasos de tango. Entonces la gente puede ver bien la anatomía, ¿no?
Igual creo que se ve, pero sí.
No sé, estos baggy pants, you know, I don't help much to see what's going on in terms of position of the legs. I noticed when I was watching from behind the cameras that Eva has her skirt and you can see her legs. It's much more clear for the anatomy. So I was wondering maybe I should bring my shorts and for the class and start teaching with the shorts.
Both. Yes, for Patricio in shorts, or no, for Patricio, no, in pants.
Bermudas.
No sé, vamos a pensarlo.
Okay.
So, vamos a ver qué dice la gente.
So, we have a low sacada, a high sacada, a low, a high, a voleo, and I will kick. And get here on that leg, give it a nice little tuck into the other heel. Uh-huh, remember that? We did that in the enrosque.
Long time ago, yeah.
That's the enrosque class. Kick, bam, and push from behind.
Look your leg, you're kicking. Esa. ¿Estamos más elongados o qué?
Well, I'm taking classes with my flexibility coach.
Nice, I like your flying leg.
The lead comes from a sacada onto a high sacada, transfer weight here to produce the voleo, and then he avoids entirely the follow, and then brings the leg onto the other side. All you need is to find clearance.
Yeah.
The shorter the follow, the easier it is to do this step, guys. So, if you want to get there, you see, it doesn't have to be too high.
No.
You need to get over the calf, and push that calf a little bit into her. Yes. I think we should use the camera three, please.
Okay.
Yes.
I think it's a good idea. Let's see if I
can do
it like this.
Yes. Oh, with the heel. Look at that.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
Wow. You got style. Let me make sure that everything is okay here. Yeah. Sometimes I mess up the volumes. And I think I kill the music.
I know. Okay, let's show this. That you want to show the
The moment in which you go forward and I get here.
Oh yeah.
I want them to see how I'm gonna step further there.
Okay. Wait. Okay.
That's the enrosque. You see, you can cross the enrosque there.
Eso creo que estuvo bien el ángulo, ¿eh? I think. I'm not sure.
That's what we're trying to do.
Nice.
This can be done simply on the front ocho, you see? So if the follow is doing a front ocho, and she takes the one that is the last ocho, you get over there, you push the heel into it, and she should cross. You should be ready for the unexpected here, but she should cross. Now, if you make your way to the front foot as you rotate your body, she should have a beautiful enrosque on the way out.
Yeah.
Yes?
What is very important is that you are not moving my torso at all at the moment that you do this with the leg. It's just the leg. You minimize the movement on your leg and nothing else. Because if not,
yes,
if the lead start shaking us or anything, we are going yes. to lose our axis.
Ding.
Let's see.
That's the ladies and Roski.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So, this is fun. There is a lot of possibilities here to make it happen. Oh, I forgot about something.
What?
I forgot to tell people about the one thing that they can do to help us continue forward.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And YouTube sent me an email, says, ask people for your support early on the video because then you forget and people go away and then you forget. So, before it's too late.
No good.
There you go.
There you have it. If you want to contribute, then these are the places where you can do it. And we always appreciate your support. Thank you so much. It means everything for us because it means the ability for us to keep doing this for you, okay? So you can watch it for all over the world and you can learn tango. Thank you for being there supporting us. So go if you can to those links and give us anything you feel that you can, okay? It can be a coffee, the money for coffee or more.
Can be dinner.
Sky,
it can be dinner.
The sky is the limit.
The sky
is the limit.
Well, we continue to invest in the studio, and we are today debuting our brand new camera switch that I enjoy a lot. And
yeah.
It is giving us more tools and more ways to continue sharing the tango with the world. So if you can support us, please do, and we will continue giving as well.
Yeah. The switcher is thank you to them too, because we could afford the switcher because they donate for the switcher. So thank you.
So Eva,
yes,
would you like to dance with me?
Of course, always.
You know what? I'm gonna tell it to you in Korean. I learned to say it the other way with my student.
Okay.
Tango chumchuga shipo.
I don't know how to say yes in Korean, though.
Tango chumchuga shipo. It means, do you want to dance with me?
Good.
Do you want to dance with me?
Yes.
Great. Thank you. La viruta.
Muy bueno.
Tremendo tango.
Es hermoso. Tiene mucha polenta. Mucha polenta el tango ese.
¿No? And the movement works really nice.
Yeah.
When you got your ears open and you can see what's going on in the undulation in the music, you can then put energy into a different movement.
Exactly.
Change the acceleration. Rashid was telling me the other day, he said, hey, Patricio, I found out that it has to do with the acceleration. And yes, because soft, fast, slow, these are different levels of energy, and we don't have a monotone movement controlling the entire dance. We oscillate as the music does.
That's what brings the flavor to our interpretation when we dance.
Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. So, we have the movement from the sacada in the front, sacada on the side, voleo. Here the follow can do in different ways, as we demonstrated during the song. You can do it low or you can do it high. If there is space and the sacada from the lead is quite high into the thigh, then the follow can swing the leg off the floor. A ver, let's see how.
¿Qué cosa?
I'm saying that the follow has choices as to how she sends her leg into that voleo, and how far the leg goes determines where the crossing of the voleo is. If she brings the leg low, her voleo will be there. If he brings the leg somewhere sideways, then she can bring it higher.
Oh, yeah,
if she sends it really far, then her voleo would be more of a crossing voleo with the thigh, with the knee far. So if the follow wants, she could send her leg far a little bit. But you have to feel how the lead is holding you, because that is a moment of stress. It's a moment of changing directions. Mm-hmm. She's swinging right to then swing left. So the lead has to be really cautious when you apply power there. It's mostly a simulation and then holding. Mm-hmm. When I do this part here, I give that energy to go, but then I let the follow place her leg where she wants it. And then I very kindly let her come down from it, but I don't apply a chiropractor-like cracking in the opposite way, you know? I always in a position where if she doesn't come to her body a lot, then I won't be forcing her. However, I do impulse a little bit in the counter direction, but the point I'm trying to make is that when she exposes her leg that much, you see, I'm here very kind. You see, sometimes we think that more power, more strength applied, it will bring better results, and that is not always the case. If some things don't happen within reason, then it's not good to try harder, you know?
Yeah. But one thing for the follows, if you are trying to do the this moment here, the enrosque, okay, when you cross behind, if you're trying to do that, be sure that the moment that you cross, and this should apply for any cross, not only for this cross, okay? But the idea is that when you cross, see this? You're going to cross with the foot flat. Be careful with these kind of crosses. Okay, it's very common that we cross with the pigeon toe, like the foot is crooked. You see that? So pay attention that when you go to the cross, that you go with the foot flat. See what is going on with the ball of the foot. And you keep this position as you pivot. As you pivot, you start either disarming that position very close to the other foot. See that? So as you start turning, you disarm that close, and you're ready. Or you go all the way forward, and then you change it at the end. See? So these are options for you. To do the enrosque and decide how you're going to exit that enrosque.
Yeah. If the follow wants to make it, see, the lead is suggesting this cross. So the enrosque is simply this, that part of the movement, in which you add style to the way you turn. See, this is an ordinary front ocho, where my feet come together. If I want, I cross back and then go.
Yes.
So this is all there is. The follow is receiving a sacada on crossing forward. She pivots, reaches sideways. As she's transferring her leg, as she's transferring her weight, look, notice this. My weight is on my right leg. I'm about to cross left. As she's transferring her weight, she comes aligned here, knee and thigh. So that's the moment where you put your leg in. At this point, she starts moving her way off that leg, and you advance further in, so then she goes this way. So then the follow receives the second sacada. She does the voleo, and here it's important to disconnect. You see, disconnect the leg from the hip.
Yeah.
So this, it doesn't mean that because you're going to do a voleo, you're going to turn your body.
Yeah.
See, the lead is only pushing your leg out this way, right? He's pushing it sideways and back. So move the glutes, move the hips. Come into the voleo. If you feel like you need to pivot a little bit, you can. But you see here, you're doing a big circle with your foot into the voleo position. Then you come out with a forward step. And then the lead has to mount over your calf in a way that it will produce this kind of drive you. It will drive you to cross yourself, because when you try to come out, you can. It's like a funnel, you see? The lead is funneling you into a crossing. If you are in the moment and you're really paying attention, then you will probably do this. Now, can you give me a little frame? Then the lead will turn you, and then you come out in a front ocho. So you allow him to, allow the lead to guide you, funneling you into the position that he wants. You see, but this is gentle. Then overturn, and then we're exiting here parallel. It can be repeated endlessly. One, two, voleo, enrosque, side step. One, two, voleo, enrosque, side step.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and another option that we have is in the high sacada, sometimes you might feel, because I did a couple of times, that instead of flying the leg around like this, you lift it like through your partner's leg. So I show you this. You have two more options. One is to kind of lift. I don't know if that's, yeah. Let's see. I don't know if the angle was good, but to see. Ah, okay, maybe this angle. Let's see. Yeah, no. I don't know if they see it, but yes, I kind of go through my partner's leg.
Like a leg wrap.
Yes, can
it's
we?
Like a leg wrap.
Like a ring wrap. Can we do it here?
Yes.
Boom. Here, instead of sending my leg around when I transfer my weight, I go through like a leg wrap, okay? In my partner's leg. Yes? Okay, a lot of options.
The good thing about this movement is that it can be done on both directions. This is why we began the class talking about crossing and like in the ocho cortado. One, two, or one, two. Mm-hmm. One, two, one, two. The voleo is there. Then the kick is there. And then the stepping out is there. So everything can be done on this side as well.
Que la hoja del cuchillo que nos hiere y que se ve más grande.
presentir la muerte que morir. Y yo con este drama, dudando a toda hora, el grito contenido, llorando hasta sangrar. No, no tengas miedo de partirme el corazón. Yo prefiero todo esto a tu enorme compasión. Basta ya, grítame brutal lo que presiento, que no me quieres más. Clávame el puñal de tus palabras, mirándome a los ojos sin temor. Clávalo, traspásame hasta el alma, si te parece poco, pobre corazón. Quiero de una vez que me lo digas, que me lo grites fuerte hasta quedar sin voz. No te calles, no te espantes, que termine cuanto antes este horror entre los dos. Así desesperado, viviendo noche y día, un drama sin palabras que duele más y más. De una vez por todas terminemos el horror de vivir encadenado sin ninguna salvación. ¡Basta ya! Grítame brutal lo que presiento, que no me quieres más. Clávame el puñal de tu palabra, mirándome a los ojos sin temor. Clávalo, traspásame hasta el alma, si te parece poco mi pobre corazón. Quiero de una vez que me lo diga, que me lo grite fuerte hasta quedar sin voz. No te calles, no te pares, que termine cuanto antes este horror entre dos.
Para que me olvide de parar la música, ¿eh? Mira, te digo.
Okay. Muy bien, ¿eh?
Ahí está, linda canción.
Hermosa.
¿Viste qué dramática, dramática, dramática? Eso se llamaba, eso era Carlo Di Sarli, era Duele Más. El cantante no me acuerdo, pero viste, era...
Exactamente así.
Tiene como mucho drama de todo eso.
Muy lindo.
And it flows, the energy of the tango.
Sí. Me gustaron tus giros al final. Hermoso.
Me inspirás, mi amor.
Ok. Vos también. ¿Qué vamos a hacer?
Vamos a mostrarles algunos detalles más.
No.
Bueno,
okay.
El otro lado ya lo hicimos.
Ah, algo que yo hice. Porque a veces, claro, cuando uno baila hace cosas, entonces después puede dar esos tips, ¿no? Es que después que él me hizo este enrosque acá, que me hizo entrar en el enrosque, en vez de mantener mi pierna baja, okay, en vez de mantener mi pierna por abajo, lo que yo hice fue esto. Mirá, crucé por atrás. Y al momento que di la vuelta acá, tiré la pierna como en un voleo antes de pisar.
Ajá, muy lindo.
Entonces esa otra opción para las follows, cuando hacen esto, when you do this for the follows and you cross behind, you can either keep it through the floor as we were doing before, or as you are turning here, you send the leg through the air like a voleo.
Totally.
It is a voleo, okay? So if you feel inspired or the music tells you to do something bigger at that moment, from this cross here, you turn and you send the leg. And then you're ready to take the step. See? So you step,
you receive this, boom, boom. Cross behind, send the leg through the air. Cross behind,
beautiful.
Send the leg, okay? So, this is another option for the follows.
One more for enriching.
Yeah.
Would be to do the leg wrap. Earlier you were doing a leg wrap that then you stopped doing. Mm-hmm. Leg wrap on the high saccada. You
yes.
have to be quick. And this is why we call this advanced tango figures, because you have to be advanced. At this point of your dancing, you act based on what you perceive you need. You're not, at this point, you're not anymore thinking, okay, what you remember that is a figure that you did. This is something that you could do on the spot, because here we're talking about combining a low saccada followed by a high saccada that leads into a voleo,
yes.
and that voleo leads into a front ocho for the follow, and in that is the getaway onto the mounting of the calf, and then the pushing onto an enrosque.
Mm-hmm.
So these are only doors that we chose to open, but for every one step you take, there are one, two, or three, or four different doors that open. And as you pick that you're going to open either or that door, then you are creating different variations.
Mm-hmm.
And at this point, then, you react based on your perception and what you consider that is happening and needs to happen. For example, I do this. Sorry, not that part.
Okay.
I do the saccada. And at this point, because she sees that my leg is there so quickly and early, she can then do a leg wrap, then follow with the saccada, go into the voleo, and continue. You see? And so this way she's adding, the follow is adding a new element to the dance, but not in a direct confrontation with the energy of the lead. It's sideways. So then it's enriching, but does not put you at risk of a direct confrontation with two different opposing energies.
Mm-hmm.
That could hurt, could mm-hmm. lead to an accident.
Yes.
And it is beautiful, because if we're dancing to slow music, you can do this really softly. Shall we do it?
Yes. So this, we show this again. I go through, so I go up. So can we go a little bit back to the same way? I mean, we position already. Oops. Wait.
Here.
Yes.
It looks like the class on Wednesday that we always end up.
So. See, when I start going up, you either put a gancho there, okay, if you feel like, or you just raise your knee up, see, and then you can untangle. Can you go a little there? And untangle me. Like. So it's not me that from here you send untangle me, the leg open like that. You could. It's not that you cannot. But also, no.
Oh, I love when you do that. When you do a fan kick like that?
Yes.
360, I love that.
Exactly. So you have options. If you feel like going up and can you give me your hand?
Yes.
And from this position, do that. You see? From my knee down. This is something you can practice, right? Because sometimes we the follows use from the knee up, from the knee down movements. When we, for example, do embellishment, usually we don't turn out the leg like that, usually. So in those cases, it's nice that you have like that control. So what I'm saying now is that when you go up with the leg, you can let that area of the leg to unhook from your partner. And from that right there, you can send the leg back. Okay, the other option is, can you give me the hand here? Thank you. The other option is that from this going up with the leg, you send it through the air. Okay? So, and you see, I'm just sending it at 90 degrees, which is high enough.
Just there.
So, if you have the space, if you have the mood, and the music is like you are feeling like you are flying, those moments that you feel so inspired, and I don't know. They are very special moments. You can do those kind of things. They feel great, yeah?
Bien.
Time. Is it time?
55 minutos en que comenzó. Tenemos tiempo para bailar un tanguito más.
Okay.
¿Qué te parece si
Let's
bailamos
do one more
tanguito?
Tango and then we say bye to people, right?
Yes.
Till the next week only. I mean, bye.
Until
for
next Saturday. We say goodbye for today.
Yes.
But we can dance a tango and explore different possibilities in the movement.
Yeah.
And so the people can see, if they are not dancing at home, they can see different ways to get in and out into the movement.
Mm-hmm.
Corazón, me estás mintiendo, corazón, ¿por qué lloras? No me ves que estoy muriendo de esta pena tu compás. Si sabes que ya no es mía, que a otros brazos entregó, no desmayes todavía, sé constante como yo. Dame tu latido, que yo quiero arrancar esta flor de olvido que aprendido sobre mi mar. Corazón, no la sabes ni la implores, que de tus amores nunca he merecido tanta humillación. Creo en Dios y la vida con sus vueltas. Sé de rodillas la traerá a mis puertas a pedir perdón. Creo en Dios y la vida con sus vueltas. Sé que de rodillas la traerá a mis puertas a pedir perdón.
Another piece of equipment we need to get is this audio Bluetooth thingy, yeah?
Right, yeah.
Next.
Soon, yes.
Very nice, my love.
Okay, very good. This was a very fun class. I mean, I'm very looking forward for next week for more of this kind of material.
Advanced tango figures.
Oh, yes, I love it.
Enough of the sanguchito, right?
For now.
Okay. Mi amor, gracias por todo.
Bueno.
Chao.
Chao,
vemos,
todos.
Nos vemos la semana que viene.
Nos vemos.
Sí. Chao en casa, toda la familia, los amigos. Nos vemos la semana que viene.
Yeah.
Yes, we love you. Thank you for being there. Chao, mi amor. Chao.
Thank you.